Good to see you. Today, we're going to paint this. The gear's already in the truck. Let's go paint. Today, I'm going to show you how to paint this with a full demonstration. I cut out all the pauses and only show you the marks being made. The drawing is sped up so we can get right into painting. Who has time to sit and watch me think about stuff? I did, but that was only to cut it out. I'm going to do the drawing and then I'm going to tell you the story of this painting like I do with all of mine, and there will be text guiding you through the process. Enjoy it, take note how I hold the brush during different stages of the painting, how the brush moves in my hand, how often I reload it with paint, and lastly, how I move it around the canvas. If at any point you gain something from the video, if you could give me a like, subscribe, or share, I would appreciate it. It'll help grow the channel, and I really enjoy doing these videos. Thank you. The story on this painting is a bit different. I live where my great uncle Charles once lived, and currently we are in the process of turning the old house into an art studio. Charles never married, and he had issues with health throughout his life. He wasn't able to take care of himself, and when my grandfather passed away, he came to live with us at my parents' house. My mom took care of him, always taking him to the doctor and running him around town when he had the idea. During the day, he would always sit out on the front porch and he would pet my dog, Annie. She was a golden retriever. She was really happy and sweet and beautiful dog like most of them. And he would stare out over the fields. Charles never said much. I knew the man my whole life, but only saw one side of him. If I could go back now, perhaps there would be more to say. But as a kid, it never crossed my mind to ask him for stories. His thoughts always seemed off in the distance. Stories about him and my grandpa, what his dad was like or how the farm used to be. Stories about his childhood and his thoughts on life are gone. There are only vague memories of Charles left with me now. When I look at this barn, it reminds me of Charles. My dad remembers back when it was full of life. Animals running around, people always outside, and things happening. I never saw the barn when those things took place. There are only little clues of it still visible. But this was painted at the start of spring. And spring always fills me with hope. Hope that I will see this barn in glory again one day. That the dreams of my family who built this barn will live on. Only one side was visible to me. The rest was a mystery. Little hints at the depths of things might be all we ever get of it. Even so, there's still stories worth telling and pictures worth painting. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.